When we started this build, we knew there were other heated jackets. In fact, we researched all of them thoroughly. The one resounding complaint we heard from the people who purchased them was, "I can't feel the heat." Well, why not? One word, power. The real issue with other heated jackets starts with the battery. Here are the batteries that most of the other heated jackets use. This is a 5-volt trickle brick. That's kind of the name we call it here in the office. The 5-volt trickle brick has very little power, but people boast about how much charging capacity it has. We'll talk about that in a second. This is a power tool battery. And then here's ours. Now, obviously, ours is going to be more comfortable thanks to the ergonomic curve that fits your body rather than sticking out like a giant tumor. But let's take a look at why these batteries lack the power that they need to effectively combat the cold. There's two reasons. Number one, most battery technology was created for charging, not heating. And when you're trying to heat, that's a big difference. And it's kind of like driving a Prius versus a Ferrari if you're on a racetrack. You really want to use the technology as it's intended for. Number two, power transfer from the battery to the heat panel. That's limited by the connection port. So the connection between the battery to the heat panel is the limiting factor. This means most batteries are set up to transfer power through kind of like a straw instead of a fire hose. So normal USB is a very low power transfer port, whereas USB-C PD, which is what we use, is a very high energy transfer port. Big difference, again, straw versus a fire hose. Okay, so first let's talk about charging versus heating. Most batteries proudly proclaim how high their milliamp rating is, saying it has 20,000 milliamps and it will charge your phone 17 times. Well, A, it's huge probably, but that's all just a ploy and it really doesn't mean anything when it comes to heat. What matters with heat is wattage. A watt is a measurement of power through a circuit, and power through a circuit is the transformation of energy to heat. It's no wonder that all other heated jackets barely talk about their battery. The other guy's battery only puts out about 6 to 12 watts of power. It's obvious that that was an afterthought for them. To create the kind of heat you can actually feel when it's cold, we focused on maximizing wattage. With our high-E ports, we were able to pump out up to 60 watts of high-energy heat, which is roughly 6 to 10 times the heat that everybody else offers, so that when it's cold, you'll actually feel the warmth. After we sorted the power out, we had to find a connection that could transfer that much energy. It doesn't do any good to create 60 watts if you can't transform it into heat. For whatever reason, the market primarily uses USB as the connection port between the battery and the heat panel. This technology is cheap, and it's everywhere. But it was created to transfer data in 1994, and it does a decent job at data transfer for a 25-year-old, but it was never created to transfer power. Most USB ports transfer 2.5 watts of power, for some of the newer ports being able to transfer a whopping 10.5 watts of power. And that's a big fail when you're trying to warm up. In order to stay ahead of the technology curve, we did what Apple did and incorporated the SuperConnector USB-C power delivery port to our power packs and our heat panels so that we can easily transfer 60 watts of power and turn it into bone-thawing warmth. We're so excited about the versatility of this new design and what it's going to bring to your wardrobe.